Some news courtesy of Variety. Charlamagne Tha God heads to Comedy Central for weekly late night show. So for sure, wherever Joe Rogan is, wherever Joe Budden is, he's probably spitting feathers, punching the wall. Because every opportunity, every occasion when it comes to dealing with big corporations and productions and, was it production companies or entertainment groups, whatever it may be, Charlamagne seems to have an ability to play nice despite having a far more checkered past than Joe Budden does. How do you compare them in terms of having scandals and, you know, controversies and flashpoints in their career? Would you say they're about the same? Because if you think about it, for a radio host, somebody that doesn't make music, somebody that just talks about stuff that's happening in culture, Charlamagne has got himself in a lot of skirmishes, right? And he's been able to somehow still, despite all that, play nice when it comes to getting on the big boy table and talking to these big platforms and whatnot. Fair enough, Comedy Central isn't what it used to be, but still, he seems to be able to play that game far better than what Joe Budden's done. And from the little experience that we know or knowledge that we have at the moment, he seems to not be able to play nice when it comes to dealing with some of these big corporations. So I wonder if he's looking at this sort of stuff more so in a way of like, oh, he's just lucky because he's just lucky, or if he's looking at it more as a way of like, oh, this is a clear indication that I need to change my approach in business, or if he just doesn't give a shit. I don't really know. But anyway, let's read the news regardless. It says here, radio personality Charlamagne Tha God has built an audience of more than 4.5 million listeners a week for his provocative observations on daily headlines, politics and trends, and pop culture. Now the author, podcast and co-host of a syndicated radio morning show, The Breakfast Club, is stepping up into the new microphone on Comedy Central. The Viacom CBS channel has given a serious order of Charlamagne Tha God's Honest Truth with Charlamagne McKelvey. That's interesting, isn't it? He put his name there. I wonder if that's a purpose pivot that he's doing now in order to kind of have two personas, so he's not just tied permanently to The Breakfast Club, because obviously Charlamagne Tha God is mostly known from The Breakfast Club. So it's an interesting way to introduce him as Leonard McKelvey going forward, right? So people can, you know, delineate between the two personas. I'm assuming the weekly half hour show to premiere September 17th, wow, it's coming up very quickly, promises to revolve around Charlamagne's culturally fluent take on social issues and also feature sketches, interviews and social experiments. So maybe it's going to be as similar to what Desus and Mirror are doing with Showtime, right? Those kind of shows where he talks about cultural event topics, flashpoints, and then is able to do some skits in between and whatnot. Sounds like a fun show. The God's Honest Truth hails from MTV Entertainment Studios. Rachel Edwards, Nick Cannon presents Wild and Now, is showrunner. Awesome tie in there. Stephen Colbert and Chris Leach of CBS The Morning Show, and Aaron Magruder and Karen Kenny, James Dixon and Norman Aladajum are also executive producers. So he's got a lot of people involved in it. Charlamagne, aka Leonard McKelvey, again, they're doing that Leonard McKelvey thing, so it's definitely a pivot away from that. Have short-lived roles on talk show comedy shows on MTV and MTV2 a decade ago, which allowed him to build a relationship with Chris McCarthy, the longtime MTV executive who now oversees Comedy Central and other Viacom brands as president. Relationships, man, that's one thing Joe Budden doesn't do, isn't it? He doesn't cultivate relationships. And I think for us as fans, we have to be fair, that is part of what kind of enamored us to the Joe Budden personality before we found out he also scumbags his friends. Because I think we were all okay with him kind of being a dick to corporations because they're faceless, but in the moment it sort of affected his friends, who we think are, they're kind of like by virtue, they sort of feel like they're our friends too, right? In Rory and Mar, that's when we all, as Joe Budden podcast fans, decided to jump ship and kind of give Joe Budden the finger on our way out. But that's one thing that he's definitely not good at. Relationships in his personal life, when it comes to, you know, dealing with his exes and baby mothers, hasn't necessarily been the greatest thing. We've obviously seen that publicized on TV. And then, of course, relationship in business, because he feels like he doesn't really have anyone rooting for him, right? That's obviously with the Facebook deal, that was one great thing he did. And of course, the Patreon thing for himself was obviously a good thing that he did as well. But other than that, it doesn't feel like he has people in the mainstream who are really trying to fight for him to get him on these platforms because his voice is necessary. It seems like he's tolerated more so, but maybe that's just my interpretation. It says here, this is one of those moments where I can show you better than I can tell you, Charlamagne said on the truth, on his truth. This is the first, I love that phrase, isn't it? He's going to do that a lot, isn't he? Remind people, this is the third talk show Chris McCarthy has done with me, and those shows prepare me of this opportunity. My South Central brethren, Stephen Colbert, is the ultimate co-sign in the late night space, and he wouldn't co-sign no bullshit. We're going to win an Emmy next year for best lightning direction, I can feel. That's good, that's funny. The Emmy he'll probably end up getting because of representation. They're gonna want to make sure that the appointment of him and the green line of this show is somewhat kind of validated. But you would hope, I would hope, that he would try to just make a good show that people give a shit about, right? People that want to tune into, don't try and court the approval of the industry. I think if he's able to get the people on board, that'll be fine. But also, maybe he's probably right in thinking the industry is where he needs to kind of put his attention, because he's always going to have the streets with the Breakfast Club. Maybe pivoting away and trying to gain the attention and the love of the normies is probably a better way to go about things. Charmin has made a career out of his contrarian reputation, calling himself at various times the Prince of Piss people off, the ruler rubbing you the wrong way, and the architect of aggravation. In his Charlemagne the God persona, McKelvey has been, see, persona, they're definitely pivoting away from this, because part of me also thinks if he's, as we've always seen, right, it seems like whatever, as more opportunities you get, they then start to turn into what Elon Musk called attack vectors. And obviously over time, whenever Charlemagne has got some good news in terms of his production, was it podcast network and other things that he's had, quite soon after has always followed the resurfacing of all those cancellation topics when it comes to the alleged rape and all that sort of stuff. And obviously got Kwame Brown, who's permanently got his foot on Charlemagne the God's neck. So it wouldn't surprise me off the back of this news if somehow in a couple of weeks' time those same articles and people and whatnot kind of rear their heads again, and then we go through the same cycle. So I'm wondering, if you're Viacom CBS, have you already gone through and done your due diligence into all the who you sign, and you're at the point where you think it doesn't matter what they say, we're going to stick by this guy? Or will they do what most of these networks do whenever an allegation that's already been spoken about prior comes up again, but it happens to catch the public's attention? Because that's a thing that I think Black people don't really kind of... they kind of not take for granted, but people don't really acknowledge Too Tough, because, you know, it is what it is. For the most part, people in hip-hop don't really get cancelled, right? They only get cancelled when it feels like the general population, the normies, decide to get outraged. So if they're able to regurgitate some of these cancellation topics again into the news cycle and somehow grab the attention of people who just watch CBS regularly, then that might be the kind of hammer that comes down and kind of kaputs this whole show. I hope it doesn't happen, of course, for him, because, you know, you want him to do his show. But it does seem to be a fairly routine cycle people go through, right? Somebody gets some good news, they're slightly controversial, they start to controversial takes from the past kind of get resurfaced, and then people start to call for them to get cancelled. Not people, you know, there's usually less than 10 of them, but regardless, they seem to be really loud, seem to be really consistent. And, you know, in Kwame Brown, you got somebody that's incredibly charismatic and funny that's doing it, so that generally doesn't help his case either. And, you know, but Sharmi's done well, though. He hasn't engaged Kwame at all when it comes to that rape allegation stuff. He's mostly, when it comes to directly apologizing for the fact that he brought up his family's sketchy past, but he hasn't really engaged that bit, which is fair, because, you know, you don't really want to go down that route, because if you do, I'm sure more skeletons will come out of the closet. It says he's a Breakfast Club radio program that originates from New York Power 105 station, and he co-hosts with DJ Envy and Angela Yee. Marked his 10-year anniversary last year, Charlemagne signed a lucrative pact with distributor iHeartMedia that called for him to launch a Black Effect podcast network and served as the company's senior creative officer of culture and content programming. It's interesting, he left, or he hasn't left, he's doing this show. Might mean there's going to leave after, but I think he re-signed a new contract, I'm pretty much sure. The other guy that with a beard that sits behind Envy, he left too. He was crying and complaining about not getting more airtime, but then he ended up getting a pretty decent deal if you listen to what he said on YouTube. Again, don't know if he's telling the truth. And then it seemed that Charlamagne went on his show and then basically said people don't play their position too much. So I don't know if this is tied into it, no idea. He's got best-selling books, says here, Charlamagne knows exactly what he wants to do with this show, which is to smack the audience upside the head every week and make sure they're paying attention to the world around them, said Magruder, creator and producer of the Bond Dogs franchise. He is keenly aware of the power of his voice and always looking to use it to maximize effect, which requires both talent and courage. Charlamagne became the sensation in the 1990s in South Carolina. He worked with Wendy Williams, but over the past decade, he came into his own with an audio era, the daily radio sport and popular podcast, The Brilliant Idiots. Oh, nice little mention there. Helped establish Charlemagne as a cultural gatekeeper for the hip-hop community. He has made 9 appearances as the guest on the Collate Show, which helped spark the partnership with Comedy Central series. Ooh, interesting. Comedy Central's been on the wane a little bit, isn't it? I think some of their web stuff and TV stuff has probably been suffering. So we need to see how that revamp goes, because it did fire a bunch of people as well, if I'm not mistaken. The two share a common trait in being natives of Palmetto State. The man grew up as Larry Kelvey, has been vocal of his work about the formative experience of his native monks. So what? Stephen Colbert's name is actually Larry McKenna. Oh, sorry, about to say that's Charlemagne. For long time, Monk's Corner, South Carolina has been unrepresented in late night shows, said Colbert. I look forward to. Oh, sorry. I look forward to all ways in which with Fearless, Peerless, Charlemagne is going to change the game. The pact with Charlemagne also brings Colbert back to Comedy Central, the outlet where he got his break. Charlemagne's thought provoking and uninhibited observations both get under people's skin, open their minds. Okay, let's see, man. Charlemagne's represented by ICM, KK Entertainment. Oh, one more K and it gets sketchy. And Del Shaw. So, yeah, good luck to him. Again, another indication of just how maybe playing the game and being media, being kind of network friendly, can really help your career, because all these opportunities are less so about him and more so about the ability to maybe get that face on TV to then allow other faces to sit alongside him. That's more you need, really, when it comes to representation. And it's good as well because you actually got somebody that's actually talented. It's not just one of those affirmative action sort of stuff. It's actually somebody that's just good at what they do, and they can obviously bring other talented people who are also from unrepresented community but are fundamentally good at what they do. They just need a chance, and then slowly but surely the TV landscape will change for the better going forward. That's all you can hope for.